Okay, that moment when you think you're recording and you're not. I really just recorded a whole video for to be in the middle and my camera just shut off and I was just like, what happened? I was gonna only do the I Choose Life one topic just once a week, but this has really just been on my mind, and because it so relates to me, I just was like, let me just make the video and I'll go ahead and record it. I'll try to post it after class. But what I basically wanted to talk about was choosing to operate through your own fear. And basically it's, whoever said you wouldn't be scared? Who said that you wouldn't be afraid? Who said, you know, and I know from a biblical standpoint and from a, you know, religious standpoint, we're always told God's not giving us a spirit of fear. And that's true. But sometimes it's okay to say I'm afraid and confront it, because there's so many opportunities that are missed because of fear. And this, you know, I think from a personal standpoint, I can be fearful of change. Changes, I like change that I am prepared for. You know what I'm saying? When you get to practice for it, if I get to practice for it, I'm good. But some change has to happen and you're gonna walk in it not knowing what is on the other side of that door. But does that mean that you don't go see what's behind the door? So it's confronting your fears and saying, you know what, fear, I know you exist. Yes, I might be scared, but best believe I'm gonna do my dang. I'm gonna try as hard as I can to just move past it. And it's easier said than done. One of my fears was probably going back to school. I mean, I've been out of school for 7, 8 years. I've been out of school for a while, but I knew that this is something personal. Most people will look at me and be like, why are you going back to school? You have no reason. You got the career, you got all that stuff. So what, you know, it is really for personal. It's personal accomplishment. And it's, of course, it aligns with, you know, some of the goals I've set for myself. But it could be, it's a fear of, you know, being out of school. And when I was in school, I was always the straight A student. And, you know, I'm a perfectionist. I'm a true Virgo. I'm a true Virgo who had to find a way to operate in the middle, because for me, I either was at one extreme or the other. So I'm either, if I'm going to do something, I want to do it perfect. If I can't do it perfect, I don't do it. And that's not the way to operate in life, because sometimes you're not going to get it right on the first time. It's so many successful people who, if you look at their story, they didn't get it right the first time. And no one ever said they weren't scared, they weren't afraid. They just operated through it and said, you know what? I don't want to curse the camera, but screw you, fear. Screw you. I am going to do what I need to do to see what's on this other side. And I'm not going to hold myself. So from a going to the weight loss, I noticed that, you know, I kind of yo-yo between certain numbers, right? Yo-yo. So I'm like, why am I afraid? What am I afraid of to actually see myself go past that yo-yo number that I always see? Why can't I keep going? What's holding me up from there? What am I afraid of? What am I afraid of? And I'm still finding that out myself. I'm gonna be honest with you, because I feel like that's one of the areas where I've always constantly struggled in. But it's operating through it. Through being fearful of something doesn't mean that you don't do it. And I'll tell you, so when I went to Jamaica, I know that I should have, my good friend, she got on a boat and I do not swim. I took a swimming class and everything and it just didn't work. I almost drowned a long time ago, so I'm a little afraid of water. But anyway, back to the story. We were gonna take this boat and it didn't have any walls or nothing. It didn't have no protection. I was just gonna be out on the sea. And I let fear get in the way. And like, the boat came, she got on. He's like, you gotta get on. And I'm like, no, I'm good. And I look back at that moment and I so wish I didn't give in to my own fears. Like, ooh. So it's looking back at life and just taking a tally of the things that you chose not to do because you let that little, I'm scared, this is not gonna work. What if people don't like me? What if people don't like it? What if people don't, you know, receive it as well? Even simple as sharing my YouTube channel. I have had this YouTube channel for 6 years, and literally fear never told my closest friends knew, but like I never announced it on my personal Facebook page, on just, you know, I have no issue with you strangers judging me, because I mean, I do care. Don't go real hard in my comment section. Don't, I got feelings. But I can deal with strangers, but if my friends don't like it, like it's fear. And why did I have that fear? So one day I don't remember who I was talking to. I was talking with one of my friends, and I went, hi, I do YouTube. Hi guys, go like my page. And I think I saw like 385 people had looked, and I was like, ooh, okay. All right, y'all don't say nothing bad. but that was fear. I was scared to just tell friends of something I enjoy. And so, I mean, I know there's bigger things, but this is just, you know, what's on my mind right now. And I'm pretty sure I don't have a clock in here, and I don't want to be late for class. So I'm going to wrap this up. So in short, I choose life. I choose me. I choose to ignore fear. I choose to ignore being scared, and I'm gonna keep going. I'm gonna press forward. I am gonna acknowledge why I am scared, why I am fearful, and I'm going to tackle it and move on. And you know, it's probably a constant thing. I mean, it's constant. I mean, there's always moments where you're scared to do something, and sometimes I just go do it. Because I'm like, just get it out of the way. But, you know, obviously some things you may have to really, really sit down and kind of figure out, you know, how many opportunities have I missed? And if I continue to let fear and being scared and, you know, of what people will think, if I continue to let that influence me, am I truly living? And I definitely am one that is at a point where I'm going to do me. I don't care unless you affect my paycheck. Now, I do care. I ain't gonna act crazy at work. I like my paycheck. But, you know, unless you are somehow influencing my life, like, you can keep your opinion. I mean, if it's helpful, yes, I'll take opinions. I'll take that. But ultimately, it's up to me. So if you don't like the decision, you're like, oh, you know, maybe you shouldn't do that just yet. Maybe you should wait till... If this is what I want to do and it's positive in my life, I'm talking about positive things, I'm going to go for it. So anyway, so no one ever said you wouldn't be scared. No one ever said you wouldn't be afraid, but that doesn't mean don't do it, because you never know what's on the other side of that door. And even if you do it and you, I like to say one of my first interviews for my promotion, I bombed that interview. It was so bad, but baby, when I started going on more, I knew my stuff, and now I'm confident in what I possess. But it took with time. Like, it took time. It took not giving in to my own fears. So all right, thanks for watching. Till the next video, bye.